That means friendship. Because we are all here, working together as one, as unity, showing love and caring for each other. So everyone here is here for our common cause. We are in agreement with what we do. And when we gather together in agreement, Christ's Spirit is with us.
Amen.
And we have to remember, one time we never said, where two or three are gathered together, Christ is there. But if you leave out in agreement, he's not there.
Who's that?
Jesus!
Oh, that's funny. Very funny. I'll be alone with this. Jesus who? Jesus Christ!
Have to ponder in our hearts as we continue our journey Now it calls for another time for sharing. Were you able to understand the message of the scripture?
Yes.
You were able to understand the message of the scripture. So we can look as pretty as we want to. We can look as ugly as we want to.
Yes.
But the whole idea is God is still not.
Amen.
He's not a servant, your servant, and my servant. Because when God does ask you for your love, remember, if you ever think about God doesn't ask us for our love, He asks us for our service. We ask Him.
Oh, hospitable to everyone, those we know. But you know one thing? When we go places, what do we usually do? Look, see where my friends sitting. Go where our friends are sitting. But today we said, go to a stranger. Reach out to a stranger. And this is what this skit was all about. Of course, the skit was really Jesus knocking on the door. This woman was totally not expecting him at all. But you know, we as believers, we must always be ready because it said in the Word, we don't know the day, not the hour. It's coming like a thief in the night. Is that sufficient?
My name is Christine Brown, and today we are celebrating Maine Friendship Day. This is a national celebration within the body of Church Women United. We're celebrating this day at the Church of Temple United Methodist Church. And the subject and theme of our service today is Open Wide the Gates.
I'm Portia Osborne, and I'm an associate minister at Third Baptist Church, San Francisco. And Brunel Hawkins invited me to come to Church Women United a couple months ago. And I'm now the Vice President for Church Women United, it's the San Francisco unit. And it's been a rewarding experience. I've heard of Church Women United for many years and have wanted to come to meetings. And Brunel just happened to call me one Wednesday and said, Portia, I have a meeting that we'd love for you to attend. Why don't you come and go and I'll pick you up. She picked me up and I've been coming ever since, and I really enjoy this ecumenical group of women who come from all nations, different faiths, and we share in our love for the community, our love for Christ, and our love for togetherness. And on today, this May Friendship Day, is a rewarding experience which talks about opening doors wide for all to come in. And so we have prayers and dedications on today. This has been a really great experience, don't you think, Brunel?
I think so.
My name is Brunel Hawkins. Living wage member as well, or fundraiser coordinator in the past.
And I'm going to be working on your next fundraiser.
All right.
Anyway, right now I'm representing my organization called Farms to Tables Urban Project. We deal with bringing fresh, organic, healthy foods to the area, San Francisco area, should I say, communities. Because you know we need to have healthy food for our young people now. Also leading into the fact that agriculture is one of the avenues that we can get our kids to further their education, such as college grants, jobs waiting for them. And I'm going to develop more camps and things for our young people, because a lot of our project programs in San Francisco lost their funding, and we're going to find other avenues such as the Village Project, African American Cultural Center. They've all lost their funding, and that's bad for young people. We have to back them. We need our help. So anything you can do, contact me at 415-671-3993. And as for me,
Brunel
Hawkins, I'm the executive director of
Farm to
Table Urban Project.
Hi, I was going to explain a little bit about May Friendship Day, which is observed by Church Women United every May. And the theme this year is Swinging Wide the Doors of Hospitality. And this picture on the front sort of says a lot of it. There's somebody from a Jewish faith and somebody from an Islamic faith, and this lady, since she's under the cross, is probably from the Christian tradition. And here we have a handicapped person, here we have a musician, we have different kinds of food, and here's rainbows. So this can mean multiplicity and variety of people, or it can have to do with gay, lesbian, and the whole umbrella. So That's I think, a very appropriate picture. Looks like it might have been done by a child or a teenager. I don't see a credit here. And our theme here, we had scriptures from Luke having to do with Zacchaeus, the tax collector that Jesus visited despite his unpopularity in the community, and explained that, that you know, everyone is welcome. And Zacchaeus repented of his cheating and everything, and became a follower of Jesus in the way of honesty and love. And so she started the Fellowship of the Base Coin, where people would give the smallest coin they had to further works of mission for people who needed it the most. And every May we take a Fellowship of the Base Coin. And we have cities. We sing together. Church Women United has women from many different traditions, faith traditions here. And we all sing together, and we learn the songs that have come up through individual ones, and then we have a song that we sing together that we know from Church Women United. This is an appropriate thing for that should be emphasized, that Jesus was about hospitality and love and openness and reaching out across all kinds of barriers.
Kind of like a faithful justice. You know, like I mentioned earlier, socioeconomic justice. This is the faithful justice.
Right.
From all people are welcome, and it's everyone treated equally, right? So
right.
Today's was like a good example with the program, and then with the food, a good reflection of that message.
Yes, that was how it was. And a lot of people contributed to the food they couldn't eat, and that was wonderful too.
My name is Linda. I'm part of the Temple United Methodist Church, where we're having this meeting today. This church has multicultural language services, English, Chinese, Fiji services during Sundays. We have a little luncheon afterwards. We have a bait program. If you call the church, they can give you information on it. If you need any issues on illegal, they can help you. We have a food bank on Wednesdays for anyone who wants to check us out. And if this book, we could give you information on where there is a space for you.
What's the address again?
It's 65 Beverly or 1111 Jupiter Serra on the corner 19th and Jupiter Serra.